live from Meadowbrook Trailer Park. And Sinead, this comes as the State Housing Board has revoked his license.
Steve, that's right. The Manufactured Housing Board voted this morning to suspend his license. That's Russ Edwards' license because of how he handled water and sewage leaks here at the park. And in a half an hour long conversation tonight, he told me that it was unfair and he puts the blame on someone else.
No, well, we've had issues in the past. They've always been corrected.
Russ Edwards says in his 20 years of owning Meadowbrook Park, he's never had major water and sewage issues. But the recent problems caused water to be shut off at the park and tenants briefly evicted. Edwards says he just didn't have the money to make repairs.
A horrible feeling of helplessness. There's nothing I could do.
As for the Manufactured Housing Board's decision to revoke his license,
the board is not capable of considering extenuating circumstances. I expect if I had died, they would have exhumed me to see if I had anything left on me worth a nickel.
He says John Walters, a tenant and former manager at the park, has been collecting and withholding $41,000 in rent money. Walters denies the claim, saying he's deposited the money in Edwards' bank account and given the rest by hand. Edwards says if he had received the money, he would have been able to fix up the park.
I'm the licensee, I'm the owner, and I allowed this scam artist to get away with this. Yeah, I'm responsible, but he's the one who has caused the problem.
Several of the other 9 tenants at the park complained about Edwards at a meeting last week. Many say he has not returned their calls.
They have never called me.
Edwards says he has signed a contract to sell the property, but since his license has been revoked, it will have to be renegotiated. Meanwhile, the tenants are trying to form a co-op to purchase the park land.
I'd like to give them equal consideration.
And Russ's license is up June 4th, and he's also been fined $5,000. Live in Richmond, Sinead Williams, WMTW News 8.